Hello, friends, do you have something what we call it as mobile or shaky teeth? Do you know someone around you who is suffering from teeth which are moving at a greater extent? Because of this mobile or shaky teeth, there are difficulties in chewing your food. Your teeth are moving so much that it is really difficult to even occlude. Is there any increase in the space? The teeth are turning yellow. And along with this, the most important reason is the mobile teeth. Are you suffering from any of this? If yes, and you want answers or solutions to this mobile or shaky teeth, then you are watching the right video. Come, let us have a look in this video on how and why should you treat this mobile teeth. What are the treatment options and what is the reason to have mobile teeth? If you don't have any of these conditions of related to mobile or shaky teeth, I would still like you to watch this video. Why? Because to avoid this condition, I am going to tell you something which is very useful tip. So keep watching.
Subscribe to my channel Dr. Mansi Shah.
Hello and a very happy morning to all of you. And here you are on my show Monday Mornings with Mansi and my YouTube channel Dr. Mansi Shah. I'm your oral health consultant and this is the channel where you get tips and tricks on how to keep and maintain healthy teeth. Friends, today as we were talking about the mobile and the shaky teeth, first let us know and differentiate about what are we going to talk today and one more other condition, what we call it as tooth infection or dental abscess. So whenever you have a single tooth infection, then that may be dental abscess, and in this condition the tooth moves up and down in the socket. That is, when you bite, you clench your teeth, the tooth goes down and then it again restores or comes up. That is because of the abscess or the collection of pus below the tooth. And what are we exactly going to talk about today? Are the mobile teeth and its treatment. So what exactly is a mobile tooth? So it is the forward and the backward movement of your teeth in its position. That the position is maintained but the tooth is moving. It is moving in the forward and the backward direction. It is quite shaky. Now, let us know the main reason why. Why does this tooth move? So let me tell you that the reason is not the teeth but your gums. Yes, your gums and the bone, they are the main players or they are the lead heroes of why your teeth are in the place. So this is your tooth. The tooth is placed or is held by a bone. And it is covered by your gums. Now, when the tooth starts moving, it is when the bone is getting loss. And why does there is bone loss or there is gums, your gums just level goes down? Why does your bone and gums level go down? The reason is the plaque and the calculus. So what exactly is this plaque and the calculus? Plaque is nothing but a yellow biofilm which has microorganisms in it. So all the yellow layer on your teeth which has bacteria, which has microorganisms in it, the ones which can lead to caries, all this is called as plaque. And what is calculus? When this plaque is hard, becomes hard on your teeth. Oh, does this really happen? And people do wait till that stage. Watch this picture. So, in this picture, as you have seen, that there is a hard deposit that has been there on the tooth. This hard deposit is nothing but calculus. So, your plaque and calculus, they are the ones which are foreign bodies or unnecessary things, the dirt in simple terms, that is lodged on your tooth. Now, as a protective mechanism, what does your body do? The gums and the bones, they try to go away from the dirt. As they go more away, more dirt is getting lodged. And this is how you lead to gingivitis or when there is bone loss, that is periodontitis. have made a video on how plaque and calculus causes periodontitis and how can we keep our teeth in a healthy state and avoid formation of this plaque and calculus. How can we clean our teeth? In between cleaning of the teeth, how it can be done. So, definitely watch the video. I am sharing the link here up. So, now, there are many treatment options depending on what stage have you visited the dentist. If you have visited in the early stage, then a simple treatment like scaling and root planing. Don't get scared, it is nothing that scary. It is just cleaning of your teeth with an scaler, which is with an ultrasonic instrument. That is called as professional cleaning. So, once you have the professional cleaning done, at home if you maintain in a good state and good condition and follow all the dentist tips and tricks, then you can have a mouth, a healthy mouth which is away from this plaque and calculus. Now, if you have visited in a little later stage where only the cleaning is not going to help, then the second option is splinting. And the third option, which is very severe condition of periodontitis, then third option is bone grafting, that is replacing it with an artificial bone, doing flap surgeries, that is nothing but doing gum surgeries, cleaning inside all the gums and then replacing it. So today in this video, we are going to discuss the option number 2. For the next 2 options, keep following my next Monday videos. So the option number 1, scaling and root planing. So what is this? So the dentist nowadays, they all use ultrasonic scalers, but there are a few where they use hand instruments. So with hand, they clean the teeth. Any of the method is fine, but with ultrasonic scalers, it definitely becomes easy and less painful and less time consuming also. So let me discuss with you the ultrasonic scaler, which I use in my dental clinic for all my patients. So this ultrasonic scaler is nothing but a pen-like thing, which has a scaler like this shaped steel-like looking instrument. This instrument gives out vibrations. These vibrations help to clean your teeth, to break down the calcified and the hard structure which is not easily removed by your brush. So for removing the hard structure of your teeth, what is exactly required? Yes, this ultrasonic scaler and its vibrations. So, I'm attaching a short clip here. Let us first watch the clip and then we'll discuss further. Clip that the ultrasonic scaler, the steel like thing that I told you, is giving out some vibrations and it is breaking down the hard part on the tooth, the hard dirt, the hard calcified material on the teeth. This calcified hard material should be removed and it is no good for your teeth. Now, after doing this procedure of cleaning, maintenance from your side is equally and very much important. Now, whenever doing this treatment, the first question the most of the people ask me, or at least the thing in their mind is, oh, is that the tooth part that is being removed? Matlab mere daant ka hissa nikal ke aa raha hai kya? Or if this treatment is done, does my enamel coating, which is the first layer, the coating of my teeth, does that get destroyed? Do I have sensitivity issues after doing this? And if I have, why do I have it? Let me tell you that this is not true. Your teeth is not being removed, or none of a part of your teeth is being removed. It is only the hard calcified dirt, the calculus, that is being removed with this ultrasonic scaler. Imagine the tooth is so hard that we need different kind of instruments to remove. It is so difficult to remove a teeth. How can just a pen-like device or an ultrasonic scaler remove this tooth. It is not really possible, right? So this, it just removes the dirt along with the water and the vibrations. The second question was, does this cause sensitivity issues? Now friends, let me tell you, if the roots are exposed or if there is a lot of dirt that has been accumulated, then for a few days, might be considered for 10 to 15 days, yes, there might be sensitivity issues. What you have to do on your side is avoid very hot and very cold food. That would take care and your sensitivity would just reside. Does this destroy my enamel coating? No is the answer. This method or this professional cleaning does not destroy your coating, but rather it prevents your teeth from getting cavities or getting damage. So it is a good treatment and not a bad treatment. Now there is also an issue of increase in the space, that after doing this treatment there is lot of space. Why? Because as I have told you in the earlier statement, I have already made a statement that this dirt, it causes bone loss and the gum loss. The gums and the bone, they move away from the dirt. So when they move away, naturally the teeth is going to come up. It is going to get exposed. So the space that is going to cause is the natural space. So that does not indicate that you are not supposed to do the treatment. You can save a lot of further complications by doing the treatment in the right time. So definitely go visit your dentist and get a cleaning setting done. Get a professional cleaning done at least once a year. Your dentist will definitely tell you if it is indicated or not indicated. But at least visit the dentist and get to know that if a professional cleaning is required. Yes, this cleaning also removes stains like pan, tea coffee stains. And it is not a whitening treatment. It is just to remove your plaque and calculus. Okay. So here we have discussed about scaling and root planing treatment. Along with that, as we are going to mainly focus on increasing on the strength of your gums, I would suggest increase in the intake of vitamin C through lemons, oranges, red capsicum, broccoli. All this have a lot of vitamin C. Intake of vitamin C prevents bleeding of gums and scurvy. Scurvy is a disease of gums. It prevents basically from pyrrhea. It prevents you from periodontitis. So for good gums, it is a yes for vitamin C. Also, if there is a lot of periodontitis or infection that your dentist is noticing, then he or she might give you a gel which is to be applied on your gums and a few antibiotics if it is required. So definitely do follow the instructions what are given to you by your dentist and keep a follow-up of the treatment that you have done. In the next coming videos, we are going to talk about splinting method and bone grafting method. So do not forget to watch my next videos and take knowledge about what are the treatment options for mobile teeth. If you are loving my videos, then definitely show some love here by subscribing to the channel. It is noticed that many of you are watching the video but are not subscribing to the channel. So please do subscribe. On this channel, you will be getting a healthy and a happier smile. I am always there to answer all your questions. So if you have any of queries related to dental issues, then definitely do mention it in the comment section below and I will answer it for you. Definitely like, comment and share it among your friends. Let them know what are the options for mobile and shaky teeth. Also, there are a few things on how to follow daily dental care, hygiene and tips. So, I am attaching the playlist at the end of the video. Do definitely watch that video on how to brush, how to floss, how to use a mouthwash. How can you maintain a good and healthy smile? Stay healthy, stay happy and be Orofit, my friends. Thank you.